Hello everyone. Welcome back to the VCELINK channel. Have you ever encountered a situation when the Ethernet cable is not long enough to connect to your device? Or do you need to join two cables together? You are here in the right place. Today, we are going to talk about our shielded Cat6 Keystone coupler. Firstly, prepare two shielded Cat6 patch cords. Factory pre-terminated patch cords are recommended to reduce error, but if you make your own, ensure they're properly tested with a cable tester. Plug one end of the cable into the coupler. Then, repeat the same operation on the other side. You will hear the clicking sound if they are plugged correctly. Then you will just join the two patch cords together and extend their length. Unlike the inline couplers, this shielded Cat6 Keystone coupler has a little tab and a flexible clip, so it can snap into Ethernet wall plates and patch panels. When you apply it to the wall plate, the little tab goes into the wall plate first. Then click the coupler in the right place. If you want to remove the Keystone coupler from the wall plate, here is a simple trick for you. See the flexible clip here? Using a flathead screwdriver can easily pry it up. The same applies when used with patch panels. Tip the shielded Cat6 Keystone coupler to hook the patch panel with the bottom tab. Then with a little force, the coupler will snap into the patch panel. Use a flathead screwdriver to remove it. Unshielded and shielded Keystone couplers. People tend to choose unshielded Ethernet couplers at home, but if the environment is full of electromagnetic interference, it is recommended to use the shielded Ethernet coupler to protect your data transmission speed. With unshielded couplers, do not use shielded cables, or it may interfere with your network. As the reverse is not true for the shielded couplers, you can choose to use shielded or unshielded cables. But you need to use shielded cables and connectors with shielded Ethernet couplers for better effects. How many Ethernet couplers can be used? It is recommended to use no more than one coupler per channel if you want your channel to keep working at your expected speed. And never use more than three couplers, or it may affect the signal. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.